watch Full House, because that's like, you won't really understand what Fuller House is. It's a sequel to it. But yeah, we're on our fourth season now. We just started about 3 weeks ago.
Hi, my name is Hunter Payton.
So how is it on A to Z?
A to Z, that was amazing. It was like the first like big TV series I was on, and I loved it because all of the people on it I'm so friends with today. Like, Trevor Markham is like my best friend. He's just really great people on the show.
So what kind of benefit from the show? I mean, what has resulted from the show?
From the show, I think I've just gotten more confidence also from the show and a little more exposure. Like, it's just, once you do your first like breaking out of the show, like stuff like that, you get so much easier to go on auditions and just talk to people.
Well, I know I've interviewed you at least 2 or 3 times, and I'm so impressed by you. And I've been doing this for 30 years, so you're going to be the next, what is your biggest star name?
I have no clue, honestly. It's like, it's between Chris Pratt and Deadpool. It's between those two. Somewhere there.
I appreciate what you guys are doing, you know, because it's hard to determine whether a child is acting up for adolescence or something actually happened or mental illness, and you guys are putting that in a category so people can understand.
Yeah, the greatest example I can use is we work closely with another organization, and they help with child prostitution and getting these girls off the street. And the sad part is that we find out these girls need help.
Yeah.
So these girls are getting into different things, and they're going to very negative, and you got people that are getting incarcerated in jail, and they need help. And all this is happening because they're struggling.
Exactly.
They're not getting help. They're acting out to get attention. It's a negative attention, but it's attention.
Yeah.
When you're being ignored and you get some kind of attention, it's encouragement, but it's not the right kind of encouragement.
Right.
It's not the positive
right.
Encouragement.
Right.
So once we can find out how they're wired and what's going on, then we can go ahead and understand these kids and become positive in their life and help them understand what's going on with them and what they need around them so they can grow. So we basically, the wings are kids, they're misunderstood, and we help them get their wings back so they can fly.
And that's excellent, because some parents who don't understand, and I've heard the stories, will put their children out of the house. Because, you know, they're acting up, they don't understand, and you guys can put meaning to that. Put families together. That's awesome.
My mom misunderstood me for a long time. I'll say that right out. She'll say that when you talk to her. She misunderstood me for a long time. And only once I figured out the disconnect and how why we went the wrong way, that whole mentality of telling, not showing. And now I can take that and that grow from that and show these parents now, as the kids are younger, to show them, not tell them. That way of involving them in that aspect, so you can show a sense of understanding instead of telling them, being misconstrued, because truly, you can't tell someone to understand if you're not in their shoes. When she spent 2 hours of the day with me, she didn't spend the whole school day with me.
Right.
So it's learning that little thing. It's small things like that she can pick around to educate these parents, to help them better understand their kids, and help you know, help them get on the same page.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. I appreciate you being here.
I just wanted to know, the past year, can you tell me any events or accomplishments that have happened for the foundation?
We've managed to help a lot of children, because we advocate for children as well as raise money for ourselves. So we meet with the parents and we try to help them identify what's happening with the children. And then we put a plan together, and then we go to the school district and try to get services for them.
What are some of the things that come up
with the families?
Yeah, that you have to help with.
The children have behavioral problems, and they don't understand what's happening with the child. Or the child makes a lot of noises during class, and it's disrupting the class. But there's an underlying cause. Behavior is the reason that's causing that, and that needs to be identified. And if they're not identified, then the child continues. And so then the teacher starts saying, oh, he's defiant. The child's identify something going on with them. Maybe they're not learning. Maybe they don't feel good. Maybe, you know, they're looking for something.
Right.
So they end up acting out in a different way.
Because they don't know.
They don't